Hello, friends. Hello, hello. I am going to give you guys, as usual, just a couple of moments to come find us here. I'm so excited to be able to share this video with you guys tonight. I know what it's meant for me and my family, and I just truly, absolutely believe that it is going to set free parents and children tonight. So, I'm just going to give you just a moment to come find me. I know it takes a while to jump on Facebook here and find the group. Hello, hello. Yeah, I'm just going to declare over your families that there's going to be a shift. I believe that you're coming tonight because when I posted about the crazy cycle, I posted about parents having a disconnect with children. You're here for a reason tonight, and I just declare that there is going to be breakthrough for you and for your children. There's going to be absolutely a shift for children in their childhood because of this video and because of this teaching that parents are going to get set free from this tonight. I am so excited. Yeah, I just see people jumping on left and right. So we just welcome you. Thank you for being with us. There we are. Hello, hello. I just always like to give you guys just a minute to come find us. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and get started. So again, thank you for joining us. And I'm just so excited for what the Lord is going to do tonight with this message for parents around the globe. So as I posted in my little advertisement piece promoting the video, I talked about the crazy cycle. And I just want to explain to you guys for a little bit what that looked like in my family with my children. There is something in my bloodline where mothers and daughters, it's not necessarily firstborn daughter, but mothers and daughters have had rejection. So the mother would get along with all of the other siblings, but she would have rejection towards one of the children. And I was the one that had that with my mother. It was very painful growing up. Come on, the person that is supposed to love you and nurture you and teach you and take you underneath their wing and embrace you and comfort you. When that's void, when that's not there, that's a very difficult place for a child to be in. And so I had it with my mother, and my mother had it from my grandmother. And so and it goes back 200 years. And so I was well aware of this even before I had children. And I did a lot of inner healing. I did some spiritual work on that to break that off in my family line. And I just declared that with my children, it would be different, that I was not going to pass that on, that the buck stopped with me and my generation, and my children would not know a day of being rejected by their mother the way that I did. And my mother knew it from, her mother and so forth. And so here I now have my four babies, fast and furious. And wow, it really came to a head. Let me say this. I realized with one of my children, now this is my child who is the most adorable. They're all adorable, but she's so adorable. She is my giver. She is my compassionate child. She is my easiest child. She is my child that probably demands the least on me. And yet there was something in my heart, like I could feel it with her. It was just this little, ugh. I could feel it in my heart. And I thought, no way, devil. You are coming, and you are trying to get this disconnect that's in my family line between my daughter and I. And it's this daughter that it's coming out on. And I thought, absolutely not. You will not have my relationship with her. And I would go above and beyond. I would go overboard. I would be like extra careful to make sure that my relationship with her is okay. I would overcompensate in great measures to go after her heart, to go after our connection. I would go on dates with her. I would check in with her often. I would give her words of affirmation. I would just do everything I could to go after her heart. And yet, 10 years into it, so 10 years I'm managing this with her. And I was out in the garage, and she came to me and she said, "Hey, mom, can I?" And I didn't even know what she was going to ask me yet. Could I have a friend spend the night? Can I go have a treat? I didn't know what she was going to ask me. And my answer was no. And I realized in that moment that when my other three kids come to me and say, "Hey, mom, can I?" My answer is yes. Because I aim to please and I love to give them the desires of their heart. And I realized in that moment, wow, I'm really not managing this very well because there is that in my heart with her. And it scared me, to be honest with you. And I don't think that this is something that I could have even admitted at the time. Come on, moms and dads, when we feel something in our hearts that we know we're not supposed to be feeling with our children, it's a scary thing. It's a scary thing to be able to, or to acknowledge, hey, I'm just not feeling it in my heart towards this particular child. It's a scary, scary thing. And so I'm so thankful for the breakthrough that we had, and that he's given me a language for it so I can pass it on to you, and so that you can also enter into this place of freedom. So this is what it looked like. And I just know from experience that this is going to be so much revelation for a lot of you today. So this is what it looked like. My daughter was partnering with a spirit of rejection, and she had been most of her life. And so it's been described as like the hula hoop. So every one of us has a hula hoop that's around us, and we have different things inside of our hula hoop. So we should be projecting, because it's within us, we should be projecting love and acceptance and faith and security and appropriate confidence and all that kind of stuff. So when people meet us and they hit that hula hoop, they should be feeling all things good, right? Because we can love, because we're loved from him first and all that stuff. But sometimes we have in our hula hoop things that we shouldn't have in there. And my daughter had rejection in the hula hoop. So it's like I'm over here, my daughter's here, and every time she would come towards me, it was, I'll use this, it was like, this is my daughter, and this is the spirit of rejection. She would come towards me, and I would hit that spirit of rejection. It was in her hula hoop. Come on, guys. For those of you that know my story, the spirit of rejection almost took my life out. I have overcome the spirit of rejection. I hate the spirit of rejection. I despise the spirit of rejection, and the spirit of rejection has no room in me, or no room in my life. And here I have a daughter that is partnering with it and coming at me with that spirit. So that in my heart really wasn't towards my daughter. It was towards that spirit that she was bringing at me or bringing towards me anytime that we were interacting. So furthering it a little bit more, I had another daughter, my twin, who is fiercely strong. She is fiercely strong. And when she was really little, I promise you, I'm only half kidding when I say, when she was five, I probably would have let her babysit simply because nobody would get away with anything. Like, she's just such a strong, fierce leader. And what I realized with her is that she was partnering with a spirit of rebellion. So it wasn't outward rebellion. It wasn't like she was flat out disregarding me or anything. But it was, come on, mom, we know what it's like when our child, it gives you a little, you know, just that little... That little thing in her heart, and I could feel it. And I, for 10 years, I would call that out. And I'm like, you said the right answer. You said, yes, mom. But I saw that there's something in your heart that resists me. And come on, I was walking that out, and that felt really scary too. And this is what the Lord showed me. You guys, here's the revelation. He showed me that I was controlling them. Wow, that is so unpleasant to hear that. But thank you, Jesus, that when the Father reveals those places in our hearts, even though it's hard and difficult to hear, he does it with such love, and he does it to reveal, to bring freedom, right? And he just does it in a way that's so tender, and it's just such the Father, right? So he started showing me that my Emma, the one that was partnering with the spirit of rejection, she was being controlled by me because she's artsy-fartsy, and I'm not. And she's like glitter everywhere. And she's like, let's cut up little pieces of paper and let's like leave them on the table for forever. And let's go to the store and buy like $30 of like new cupcake stuff. And like, let's make a mess in the kitchen for like hours. And let's just like do grandiose painting and whatever. And I believe in art for children. And so I would say yes to her, but it was within my box. So it was neat and it was tidy and it was for like an hour or so, and we're going to package it all up and we're going to put it away. I don't like mess and I don't like chaos and I just don't like that. That's not how I'm wired. And so I was putting her, this creative girl, in this box of trying to be more like me, and it wasn't working. And for my other daughter that was so strong, I was controlling her because she threatened me. If I was to be really honest, she threatened me. that I felt like as a mom, I had to have more authority than you do. And I have to be stronger than you are. So if you're a strong little 5-year-old girl, wow, I've got to be a really strong mom. And what it looked like was trying to put them in a box that made me feel comfortable. But they're not made in my image. They're made in his image. And here's the thing, guys. God is pretty passionate about control or about the lack of control. He, in fact, puts before us life and death, and he puts before us heaven or hell. He puts before us a relationship or non-relationship, and he says the choice is yours. He doesn't control us. He doesn't manipulate us. He doesn't bribe us. He simply puts it before us, and it's our choice, and he respects whatever choice we want to make. And so as parents, when we start using control to control our children, to be in our image, to be in our box, to make sure that they are living a life that keeps us comfortable, we actually are not partnering with the Father's tools. In fact, we're partnering with the enemy's tools. And that's not the way God's designed it. So here I am, and I'm controlling both of my girls in different areas. And there's a healthy way to respond. Heaven has something to say about when you are being controlled by somebody, and it is possible to respond in a healthy, heaven, Christ-like way. But come on, because control is a tool of the enemy, and he does everything diabolical, and he does everything. We've got some thunder going on. I hope that's not too loud here. But anyway, he does everything in a calculated way. He has one person controlling, and he quickly hands the person on the receiving end of that two tools. And it's either the spirit of control or the spirit of rebellion or the spirit of rejection. So what was happening is my daughter would come towards me with a spirit of rejection. I'm coming at her with a spirit of control. She'd come at me with a spirit of rejection. And there'd be this thing in the spirit between these two spirits. And I'm over here, my daughter's over here, and we're not connecting. Because these two spirits are at battle that we are carrying towards each other. And again, my other daughter, it was my control and it was her rebellion. And come on, when a child is being rebellious, what does a parent do? They get more controlling. And when a parent is being controlling, what does the child do? They get more rebellious. And it just keeps feeding each other. And what does connection do? It goes right out the window. It goes right out the window. So for me, again, this went on for 10 years before it finally got broken in my family. And what it looked like with my daughter, the one that was partnering with the spirit of rejection, is I took her on a date in the driveway. I didn't have time, and I couldn't get another sitter for the other kids. And so I busied them with a movie, and I took her out on the driveway, and we sat out on the driveway, and I explained this crazy cycle to her. And we both cried and we wept, and she confessed to me. She said, "Mom, all the times you would take me out on those dates, all the times you were trying to make me feel so special." And she said, "My mind knew that you loved me, but my heart could never feel it." Oh, man, that just broke my heart. And we decided that we needed a code word, that when I was partnering with the spirit of rejection, or she was partnering with the spirit of rejection, that we had a code word for each other. And she said, "How about, Mom, if I just say, 'Mom, you're being controlling.'" And I said, "Yeah, in the moment, that's probably not going to be the best thing to say to me." So we came up with the term the crazy psycho. And it's only been about 2 or 3 times since then where she has come at me with a spirit of rejection. And I felt that riling up, like I want to reject her in the moment, coming underneath that. And I said to her, I said, "Sweetheart," I said, "is this you? Or is it this the spirit of rejection that's talking?" And she kind of took a minute to process it. And she said, "Yeah, that's the spirit of rejection. I don't need a partner with that anymore." Anyways, so we were able to break that. And we all needed to ask for repent and ask for forgiveness for partnering with the spirit of control, the rebellion and rejection. And then we asked Jesus to come in and to reteach us how to be mother and child without those tools. How to respond to each other without those tools of the enemy being present. So anyways, I just feel like that's going to be such a revelation for so many of you. If you are seeing rejection, or you are seeing a child partner with a spirit of rebellion, I just want you to be asking Holy Spirit, is there an area in which this child is being controlled? Is the spirit of control in operation where they have to pick those two tools in order to defend themselves? And I just want to clarify, it's not just adults that can be controlling and children partner with that. Children can be the controlling ones, and parents can partner with the spirit of rejection or the spirit of rebellion with children. Absolutely. And I also feel like it's really important to acknowledge that controlling our children is not all, even though it's not a tool that we want to be doing or using, it's not always like trauma and abusive. So when my daughter says, hey, can I go play with glitter and paint? I'm not being abusive by saying no to her. It was more of my personality and my likes that were clashing, if that makes sense. And the other thing is, children can feel controlled because they have a sibling that's special needs. And that affects what they want and their ability to fly, because there's other demands and needs of the family that are taking precedence. Children can feel controlled because daddy's a really good provider and he's off on business trips for weeks at a time. So control doesn't always mean that we're necessarily our heart's wrong. It doesn't always necessarily mean that we're bad parents. It just means that there's something in operation where that child is feeling controlled and in a box rather than free to fly to be who they are. So anyway, I hope that makes sense. I also want to just highlight when there's that in your heart with a child, and that one particular child for you just stands out from the rest, and it's like you just have the hardest time trying to connect with them. I see this a lot. It's because the child is carrying something that they should not be carrying, and it could be unforgiveness. I've seen mothers have come to me. One mother in particular came to me and said, it's like my son divorced me a year ago. And he will not let me hug him. I can't tie his shoes. It's like he just doesn't want anything to do with me. And come on, that broke the mother's heart. And what it was in that particular situation is the mother had to make a very, very difficult decision to protect her son. And there was a bona fide, real risk to the son. And the mother had to make a hard decision. And the son did not understand the mother's position on that. And the son had a wall of unforgiveness towards the mom and was pushing her away because he had not dealt with the offense and with the unforgiveness. And that was creating a wall between them. And when Holy Spirit started showing this to the mom, we were able to work through some creative ways with this child to work through forgiving the mom. And instantly their relationship was restored. Sometimes our children are partnering with a spirit of fear. Sometimes our children are engaging in behaviors, could be pornography. It could be that they are going through something with children on the playground at school, and they are full of shame. They're filled with guilt, and they don't know how to connect with you, or they're purposely pushing you away because the weight of what they're carrying or what they're going through. So if there's that disconnect between you and a child, be tracking with Holy Spirit. Is this child going through something that I need to be made aware of? I can tell within minutes, within literally, like I don't believe the sun goes down, that when my children are partnering with guilt, or they've come under something, or they like they've been exposed to something, participated in something, and I can feel it almost immediately how they start pulling away from me with that. Anyways, so that's a big thing that I want you to take into consideration. Maybe it's not you at all. Maybe it's something that the child needs to get set free from. Lastly, I just want to share this. You know, the Lord is all about family. He loves family, and he knows exactly what he's doing when he put mom and dad and child together. And there's a package mix. It's not just mother and father and child. It's like that we all go together perfectly. And I just, again, I see this over and over and over again. You have adults, you have parents who did not get what they needed in childhood. And so they now become parents and they have children. And I'm not saying that that their children parent them, because that would just be weird. That's not what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is when we become parents, it gives God another opportunity to parent us through our children. So I'm going to give you a couple of stories. Just recently, a dad had confessed to me, yeah, there's just this between me and just one of my children. It's just me and one of my children. I don't know why I feel this way towards them, but we're just not connecting. And come to find out, the dad was partnering with a spirit of fear that had been in his life for years. So since he was a small child, and he needed to be radically set free from that spirit of fear. And so, come on, guys, the dad's partnering with fear. This child comes, and the child is like, whoa, that spirit of fear in your hula hoop, dad, doesn't feel safe to me. It doesn't feel good. And so that child was actually then kind of pushing the dad away or had a hard time getting close to the dad because that fear was there. Come on, you guys. This is glorious that the dad was feeling the disconnect that caused him and put pressure on him to seek the Lord as far as what is wrong with my connection with this child. And God revealed that there was something in the father that needed to come into an alignment. I had another situation just recently of another father who came and said there's such a disconnect with him and his daughter. And he was grieved over it, that every dream he's ever had with him and his future daughter was not happening because there was such a wall between them. And that too, God revealed that this father had endured something awful when he was 12 and that he got set free from that. He got set free from the stuff that he's been carrying around with him since he was 12 years old. And what did God use? God used the disconnect between him and his daughter to reveal what was going on inside the father's heart. I could tell you countless stories of times that there's been something between me and my children, and the Lord has revealed, no, Lisa, that's your issue, that I am using your children in this situation to redeem and to heal something inside of you. So I've come to this place when there's that in my heart or in the spirit with one of my children, that I stop and I ask, I say, Holy Spirit, is this an issue between, is this their issue or is this my issue? Because their issue looks like something they're carrying. Come on, I'm their parent. I want to help them with that. You can't help them and create a solution unless you know what the problem is. Right? And sometimes we need to be tracking with Holy Spirit as far as what the real issue is. It could be a character issue for them. They just don't know the word no yet. They just have not yet learned that the world does not revolve around them. Come on. That's a their issue. And we need to parent those places. But sometimes when we feel that in our spirit or in our hearts with our children, it's because God wants to do something in us. And so I just want you to just be open to spending time with Holy Spirit. And with that child that you're feeling that with, be asking him, is this something in me that needs to come into an alignment, that needs to be healed or needs to be redeemed? Okay? So, I'm going to keep this video a little bit shorter today, but I hope that blesses you. I'm going to stay on Facebook. I'm going to shut off the live video. I'm going to jump on Facebook. If you guys have some questions or if you have some specific situations with you and your children that you guys want to talk through a little bit, go ahead and post it on a post and I will be sure to respond. So again, I just bless you for acknowledging that there's maybe a little something on your heart towards your child. I bless you for being intentional and I bless you for being hungry for heaven's tools and keys for setting your family free. All right. I love you guys. Thanks for being with me today. And again, post your questions and I'll answer it there. All right. Be blessed.